I'm a bit nervous still, but I'll get over it.
Yeah. What are you nervous about?
Flying. I've never been that keen on flying.
See? Yeah. Nice.
This is Johnny.
You seen our plane? It's huge.
Oh, shit. Shit. We're leaving right now. We're on the plane, the propellers are spinning, and fingers crossed.
Eccentric cross course, and that's when I met Sadie. Just thought she was about the same to leave.
First impression of Sadie was she's barking mad. She's as mad as a hat.
Sadie is my guardian angel. She's been sent from the heavens for me. Right about now, I don't see anybody else trying to help, man.
Myself, what have I done to deserve this? Must have been a nun in a past life.
You lived all your life?
Yeah. I'll see you Monday. I'll show you where she can get some darts, man.
I'm at home!
When I first told my friends that I wanted to work as a volunteer mentor in Sighthouse Young Fence Institute, then they thought I was mad. But when I said I'm actually going to the Caribbean with three persistent young offenders that I've never met before and who don't know me, and that I was going to take them on what I hope will be a life-changing experience, they thought I was clinically insane.
Yeah, this is me for the rest of the day. I'm the sort of person, yeah, if somebody like raises the bar for me, yeah, I'll match it.
Jeffrey, we might need you as a crew member upstairs.
Yeah?
Where's she going?
Sleep, bro. Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate. There's so many opportunities that people just don't see. There's things that are going on that like you can't really comprehend unless like somebody shows you, and that's why I'm glad like I've got this opportunity to just open my eyes. Yo ho, yo
ho, a pirate's life for me. How did you feel when you found out you were coming?
It was
quite a rush, wasn't it?
Wasn't expecting it. Pleased, man. One of the best things that's happened. Yo ho, yo ho, a
pirate's life for me. What happened to your hand?
I was fighting with my brother. And
with your brother? Like, older or younger?
My twin brother.
You've got a twin?
Identical twin.
Wow.
So how's he feeling about you coming away?
I think he's jealous, man.
Well, he's going to be able to watch the DVD and then say to everyone it was him. Ne'er-do-well can't string up
behind your hole. I'm at will of my armies. It's an opportunity of a lifetime. A year ago, he wouldn't have had this opportunity. This wouldn't have happened. We extort, we pilfer, we pilfer. You see the mark on magazine?
No, I haven't. Yeah. Fantastic.
I'm so proud of him. It's like,
oh my goodness, look at you. You look like a movie star.
It does. For bangers and quaggers and ne'er-do-well cats, drink up behind your hole.
I'm at will of my armies and bangers. Bad weather coming in. It's coming from the north.
Is it still raining outside?
No.
I'm surprised I haven't puked all this up and down, up and down. He didn't know what he's doing, so today we'll get some practice in for him.
Negative 3, number.
Master. Call me Boss Prod.
So how did it happen exactly, Christopher?
That cost you a boat it. A big wave came in, so he's been like that, and it's come right up, and he's filled back, and it's been in his legs.
You saw what happened when, you know, we nearly capsized, just right by the shore. That's the dangerous place. Yeah. Once you get over that, you're safe.
Yeah.
And nothing's, I mean, today it's like a mill pond. But it's just that little bit of surf.
I seen a lady last year, a little monarch.
Yeah.
Broke her 2 feet right there.
Really?
Yeah, did she slam her on the shoulder.
One down, two more to go. That might be him.
He carried on with the boy.
Well, where is he? He's never sailed before in his life.
He's just there. See that little one
that
over
little
there?
That little boat there.
Sam, did I see you had an accident?
As soon as I found out.
And they were like, something's happened to your friend. And I was like, okay. And then
that
I jumped
the
on.
First you heard
that's,
about
that,
it.
That was the first I heard of it.
Well, no, like you should have waited.
Anymore. I apologise for just disappearing a minute ago, but I actually was having a good time.
Listen to what I'm saying. Look, I'm not going to judge you or tell you how to leave your life. You're all adults. You're all 20. But there's something else which is upsetting me slightly more. We heard you discussing it, so we know you've all been smoking spliffs, basically. I don't think, and
not
I think that that's...
Yeah, Chris doesn't. Chris doesn't.
Okay, well, you two have.
I admit it. I honestly admit it.
Let's face it. It was as much that that caused the accident that happened today as anything
today,
else. Well, you were asking about it because we heard you. Be truthful.
All right, the truth is there's about 500 people on this island in the Grenadines that will ask you to buy a drawer and stuff.
Yeah.
And, like, people will just give you zoots as well because there's so much punk around here. And we've had, like, a few joints, like, joint ends that we've smoked in the morning and stuff like that.
Smoking in the morning? We went on some boats, we had a spliff. We walked down the beach, we had a spliff. We watched a bit of TV at Brian's, we had a spliff. We went to bed. Great. That's exactly why I brought you here.
I'm glad you put it like that. I'm glad it's out.
I'm just being completely honest with you. I used to smoke weed when I was your age. I did that, exactly the same thing. But the difference was, I would pay for it with my money, not the money that I gave you. And it would be on holidays, which I'd pay for myself. And also, the heat here, you're not used to it.
You've got to have a clean mind.
Honestly, giving up weed was the best thing I ever did.
What have I done? We fucked up. We have fucked up in a way, though. Still, I really don't want Sadie to just drop us like a ton of bricks. Well, me.
How dare we treat her like this? There goes a bottle of coke.
I'm not even going to lie. I'm charged now. I'm lean. But I didn't crash no boat, that's what I'm saying. That's the worst thing, like, it's like, you know the devil, yeah? The devil will tell you the truth, and he'll tell you a bit of truth and a bit of lies at the same time. I haven't smoked any joints today.
Woo!
And I smoked, like, one cigarette, and I'm gonna try packing this now, because I'm happy about that.
You sure you're telling the truth?
Yeah. Do I seem like I'm telling the truth? Even I tell the truth even when I'm lying.
No, that's my line. I always tell the truth, even when I lie. Basically, despite having weathered perfect storm conditions on the sea, we haven't been able to catch a single fish.
Wow! Woo! Oh my God, Christopher!
We've got a fish!
Yeah! It is a shark. Go and gut it so we can eat it quick.
We be burning, not concerning.
You've been in a lot of fights, haven't you? You got stabbed.
Aye. The captain said he's been suicide, man. I'm so bad at you, though, good.
Yeah. Why did they stab you, do you think?
Because I'm scared of the area for them.
Post-war sort of thing.
Aye.
Why did you join the gang?
Just for school, man. It wasn't our choice, it was just the benefits. Like, well, there's any benefits.
Chris was telling me he wanted to leave Glasgow.
Yeah. Leave Glasgow?
Starts off Stex Blex. bottles. That was a bottle, done that. Then 16, 17, it turns into knives and swords, machetes, and but you get about 19, 20, people start buying guns.
Are you in the gang still? You'd get out of that.
If you weren't in a gang, you would think it was safer. But really, it's no safer.
Well, that's what gang I was in, Valley.
But if you're not in a gang, that doesn't mean a gang's not gonna stab you, you know what I mean?
What was your worst experience?
Like, attacked by a machete, that was all.
You got attacked by someone with a machete. Oh my goodness, your fingers are really
crooked. See, I've got scars here, scars there.
What about your brother? Because you fight with him a lot, right?
That's my best battle.
Done my horns again, fighting with my brother. And I had a knife, and I chased him, and I was angry. So I went to stab a door. Then my hands just slided through, and for the buddy I know, all their brothers, they all fight with each other as well.
It's good that you can just be honest, so you can just get on with things and move forward.
I think you guys can go all the way to the stars. You just have to believe, and I'll always support you. Way after this trip.
I'm glad.
Oh,
I'm
thank you.
Oh, I'm going to cry.
Yeah, now it's time for the big change now, isn't it?
Exactly.
To get onto that next level, because that's what it's all about now, isn't it?
I'm not out to be here for myself. I'm
just,
I like to go somewhere, I can be myself. I've not got all the pressures that Glasgow
are
on about this,
not. You seem like such a gentle person. Just the last person in the world I'd expect to, you know, be in all these fights and in and out of prison. And I think you'll make a horsey sailor.
Evidence that you did work. It's only the sturdy and hard and tough sailors get bruised.
Nearly capsized, right from the shore.
That's how the professionals do it!
They were all good. They were all good. Yeah, they're great too. And for the first time in a Dublin boat, the guys did pretty well.
Quite surprised. Sam's like, you know what he's doing sort of out there.
How was your sail, Sam?
Really good.
Good. You like the double ender?
Yeah, a little bit of getting used to, but I think a bit more practice and I'll get used to it. Yeah.
So what were you doing? Just working the jib?
No.
Not the jib. Is it the jib?
The tiller. You got me actually main sheet and tiller. I've got me proper sailing.
No, what, the whole thing?
Jesus. He said he's all surprised him.
No.
Yeah.
Is it?
All right, Alan, thank you so much for that. Bye. Basically, 60-foot yacht. Get to sail it all the way to Venezuela.
Baby's got some good news.
Yeah, again?
Yeah, go and ask Sadie what her good news is.
Are we all happy with that, or would you prefer to stick with the double enders?
I'll prefer to go to yachting. Can somebody pitch me my way?
We're going to get on a yacht.
What's that? So it's a proper big boy yacht.
It's a proper big boy yacht. Proper pirates.
Oh my.
In luxury.
Days. Can you believe it?
How's your Spanish, guys?
Terrible.
I can say you can come back to my room. No, I can't, I'm lying.
Your mouth, Jeffrey.
Even when I lie.
Young.
I'm excited.
Brian, thank you so much for looking after these guys. I don't think you're going to miss them as much as they're going to miss you, Brian. I love you.
Feeling sad, how you have to release your son, man.
Really?
Yeah, they feel sad. That's it, and we kind of just was getting into the.
Yeah.
We definitely have to go. If you have to go, you have to go. Yeah.
nice people, isn't it? They're nice people.
They're really nice people. Don't get it wrong, Jeffrey. You can come back, you know. When you can sail.
Mm. Nice family. Mm. Don't really get much time with family as well.
Sweetie.
It's nice, just living with the family.
How old were you when you lost your mother?
11. Like, since my mum passed away, I've been like running away from everything. I'm like a nomad in a way. I only spend like about 6 or 8 months in one place and then I'm moving.
What about your dad?
I don't know my dad.
Right.
My mum left him when we lived in Kenya.
I think all my life, because I haven't had a father sort of thing, I do look for like male kind of role models quite a lot.
Because my mum was a big part of my life, that's probably why I've gotten in a bit of trouble.
Sure, you were at Felton, weren't you?
And Woodhill.
And Woodhill. What was that for?
One was for a breach of probation, a common assault charge.
Right.
And I went Felton on remand for 10 weeks, but I didn't get charged with anything except possession of cannabis.
When I got banged up in Felton, it was actually like a relief sort of thing. It was like the first opportunity, like in since my mum passed away, that I actually didn't have to pay any bills. Like I had like sheets washed for me, and like in jail, it's like they basically hold your hand everywhere because you're like handcuffed. It's like you're basically like demoted into like a 5-year-old, like an infant sort of thing.
Hey, and we're like a family. Me, Johnny, Christopher, and Samuel. One happy family.
How are you feeling, Sam?
I feel alright. I'm a bit upset that I'm leaving, man. I feel like I made another family. I know he's my dad and you're supposed to love him and that, but I just don't like him. He may say that he loves me, but I've not seen any evidence of it. To me, it's just a word when he says it.
I'm always excited to go to new places. Just upset to leave the old ones behind.
They're all exactly the same. What about you, Chris?
Excited.
Oh, shit! Get your towels ready, it's about to go down! Everybody in the place hit the fucking deck! But stay on your motherfucking toes!
I'm on a boat and it's going fast and I got an article theme, patch me to Afghan. I'm the king of the world.
Why's your day been ruined?
You, Johnny, you just ruined my day.
How did I ruin your day?
Today, we were at the shop, we were trying on a few gloves. I chucked one of the gloves inside the bag for Sadie to buy us, because obviously Chris's hands is fucked up, he needs a pair of gloves. I forgot about the gloves, picked up a few other stuff, like a notebook and a harsh weather sailing book to take with us, but that everything already went through the till, and I still had the gloves, and now there's a big deal made out of the whole situation because I forgot to put the gloves back.
Chris seems to have a good pair of gloves that he's been wearing the whole time. Okay, so explain why you've told three different stories to three different people.
Because when I came,
he told me that.
He told me that he found them, and then he told me that Chris had lent them to him.
No, first of all, I said because Sam. Hold on, Sam was on the deck here and he goes, what was it, a 5-finger discount?
The shop owed you a pair of gloves.
No, they didn't owe me a pair of gloves.
Why didn't you tell me the honest story? And then I wouldn't have had to go to Chris and say, did you lend Jeffrey those gloves? Had you been caught putting them in the bag, we'd have spent the rest of the day in the police station. They don't have very lenient laws around here about things like that. What would you suggest that we did now?
I don't know, Johnny. I don't know. You're just stressing me out. I'm a million miles away from home. I don't really want to be stressed out like this. But I even said to you, Johnny, I didn't want everyone knowing about this as well. I don't know why you're bringing out the camera. I think you should turn it off as well, please. Do you mind if we take it, turn it off?
Is this a cookery show?
Jeffrey cooks up trouble. I adore Jeffrey, but sometimes I think he's got this real victim mentality thing. Instead of focusing on what is the right thing to do to make a situation that he's created better, then he just basically looks for someone to blame. I think generally, if a pair of gloves getting stolen is the very worst thing that happens on this trip, I'll see it as a roaring success.
Just that pair of gloves, it's a big fuss.
He pure and simply stole it. He put his hands in them and took them away.
Yes, I tell the truth, I did steal the gloves. I took them.
Nice conditions, it wouldn't be that big a problem, but it's not. It's very difficult conditions. And even people who've been out on the water before can get into trouble. Remember the wave we had just before we got by the underwater volcano?
Yeah.
Well, it's like going through 22 hours of that. Once we commit to that, we've got to go through it. From here, that's almost 300 miles. Okay?
And then
so that's
do that,
a lot of sailing.
We've got
rough
to drop
waters.
You off and leave you at that point.
If for any reason somebody has a serious problem with offshore sailing, it's going to be real hard on them. Because it's going to be motor sailing directly into those waves. Going into big waves is a very rough ride. And that's why we're strongly suggesting not going to Venezuela.
I'm trying to keep it together, but this is about the hardest thing we're about to do. We're gonna go sail into the night soon. We might not make it to Venezuela. I hope we do.
What stays off the boat? Dignity, self-respect. Stays off the boat. And how do I flush it?
Do I do it? Probably.
Only another 23 nights to go.
Guys, we're going sailing. We've got to get up. Sam?
Mm-hmm.
We're going sailing.
Okay.
You ready, Chris?
Aye.
Yeah?
Ready for an all night.
Going on a night sail.
Early in the morning.
Hopefully before dawn.
Probably around 10 to 15 right now, but overnight mostly 15 to 20. 6/8 of cumulus, some all the cumulus left over, flat clouds. The pressure is 10.14. The temperature 2.4 degrees Celsius. Relative humidity 71%.
You cannot defeat the sea. You have to learn how to exist within it. If a life on the sea is what you want.
I can hear it coming, yeah.
Because you had squalls coming through, you had rain, you had no wind, it's like no wind 1 minute and loads of wind the next.
Being pushed my limit is my comfort zone. Like, yeah, yesterday when we were going through the stormy season, I just had a big grin on my face.
You were in a really difficult place. You were telling me, I didn't know whether you
weren't. That's right.
Okay,
well,
just
talk
like
about?
You know.
I pretty much saw my best friend die when I was like 13, big rover, scooped him up, broke both his legs and he hit the windscreen. And I thought I got over it. And then my nan died and then it just hit me hard.
Heroin?
Yeah, I've been on that, yeah.
The fact that you were able to get yourself off that without
it's thanks to my family as well.
Absolutely.
You know? I said, Mum, I'm going to be ill for the first week. I'm going to be moody. Just leave me to it. If I snap at you, I'm sorry. But I can't really remember it because it's just not something I want to remember, it's just something I just want to forget about and just get over it. Well, I am over it now. I haven't touched stuff in three almost.
All you can think about heroin is where your next hit's coming from.
Exactly. Or what you're going to do to get your next hit.
What you're going to do to do it, exactly.
Yeah, if anything controls you, what is the point?
Exactly.
I won't be in control. I won't know what I'm doing. I don't want to be dependent on a substance that's going to kill you one way or another.
You never answer a question lightly. You always think.
Part of my autism, it takes me a little while to adjust. I've got to adjust to things first before I open up. It's taken me 3 years to get from being a complete bum and just dossing around, smoking weed, not caring about anything, and getting into trouble with the law. So I just didn't know how to cope with life and deal with things. Mm-hmm. But now I'm still finding it a bit tricky, but I'm dealing with it the best I can. Mm. And not giving up, because if you give up,
absolutely. I think you're amazing, and you get a little bit, kind of like.
Moody. I do get a bit moody.
No, I wasn't going to say that.
That's just how I deal with things.
I think you're hard on yourself, Sam. I think you're amazing.
I've got to be hard on myself. I've got to improve myself every.
Well, that's good, but also give yourself a pat on the back now and again. I'm crazy and I just forget things and lose things all the time. Now I'm just like, well, whatever. Okay, what's good about me today?
Never, ever, 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 ever let on a speedboat. Anything that has a motor, don't do it. Woo! I'll never forget that experience. It was like a ride.
I love roller coasters.
Roller coasters, you may flip the boat. Oh, I was petrified.
Thank God you came, Sam.
Yeah, thank you.
we've come like, to the point in the journey where we've realised that even though that you brought us out here to change our lives, it's not like you can only take us so far. Like,
it sucked us to the other days.
As long as it's meant and not just words. You know, because you've got to feel it. There's no use just saying what you think everybody wants to hear. You've got to mean it in your heart.
I've learned that I need to express my feelings more and talk about my problems and that, because I don't really do that. always hided stuff from like my mum and dad, never told them the truth ever. Never spoke to anybody about my problems, no. I don't like speaking to people about them, so I don't know what that is.
The most important thing I think I've learned on this boat is that I can't blame other people. It's only us that can change ourselves. If you want to be one person, if you want to be the good person, or if you want to just go back to that old life.
Absolutely, life's a process of self-creation more than self-discovery. You decide what you want to do, you decide the person that you want to be, and then you just be it.
Because when people see this, I want them to actually know exactly how I feel and stuff.
Well, that's important. So you have to tell us how you feel.
Somebody can learn from the mistakes that we've made, maybe.
I don't care about other people. I want you to learn from the mistakes you've made.
Yes, I will adopt you all.
I'm dreaming about places like this, but it's just not... You just can't picture it until you actually see it.
Takes your breath away.
It's just beautiful. Oh, I'm never going to forget this the rest of my life.
Oh. It's hard, for anyone to actually give a damn about other people's situations or their feelings.
She's your own person.
She makes you believe that you can go anywhere in the world you want, do what you want.
She's an interesting character, she's a beautiful person.
That's what I like, Sadie, because she's honest.
The guys are having a deep moment contemplating what life could be like.
I just want to have a moment of clarity where I'm like, yes, I found it, the answer's finally there.
What's the question?
What's life got in store for us?
The bullet holes scarring the walls of the infamous Rodeo jail hint at the turmoil within. Here the guards are outnumbered 12-1. The prisoners rule the overcrowded and filthy cells. 6 million handguns are in circulation in Venezuela. Street crime and corruption are rife. Studies suggesting police are part of the problem. The creaking prison system can't cope with a crime wave which has made the capital Caracas the most dangerous city in the world.
One of the most notorious prisons in Venezuela. Basically, it's like anarchy in there. They're all allowed to wander around with automatic weapons.
Are those gunshots all over the walls?
I thought I knew what rough was, but this is something else.
What's that?
Well, our driver is talking to a friend of his that's inside the Rodeo. We can say that we're friends of him and we can get inside.
Would you go in?
Yeah, I would, definitely.
But it would only be you.
That's okay. Do you want more? Shit.
No, I didn't actually think I'd be back in prison so quickly.
Yeah. Chris, Sadie, Sam,
and Ask him, does he know by anybody that's been charged with a minor offence and been murdered inside?
Pregunta si conoces a alguien que haya entrado por una ofensa menor a la cárcel y que haya pagado un tiempo exagerado por la.
Muchos.
Lots of them. Anyone that commits a minor offense has to become a monster inside the jail.
So, doing stuff that you make no what to do?
Being that there's so many gangs inside, you have to consider killing someone as a way of surviving in there. And here, the most violent ones are the younger ones. This is a new fad to cut people in pieces. When you have a mutiny inside, the National Guard from the outside with a submachine gun, on 30 millimeters, shoot on the walls.
Did they aim at the prisoners or are they just shooting the walls on purpose?
Que se apuntan a los prisioneros o solamente las paredes para
se apuntan entre sí. Los prisioneros los apuntan a ellos y ellos a los prisioneros y se disparan.
They shoot each other. Prisoners towards the guard. Inside a jail, one grenade might be $1,000.
Una subametralladora.
A Uzi. You can get it too.
Mira.
Oh, God. I can't believe someone just took the rifle out. Oh my goodness.
Mira, ve, mira, mira.
Wow.
Hey, did they all happen in prison?
Sure, yes, good.
Todo eso te pasó dentro de la
cárcel.
Sí, la mayoría de los me dieron 16 tiros.
Yes.
16 gunshots he got in jail.
16.
Makes you look like Mary Poppins.
He's a survivor. Pero Cristo me libertó.
Christ
set him free.
Thank you. Thank you.
Did you imagine anything like this was like going on? You see a little bit on the telly and stuff, but you don't see like you see the worst bits on the TV and stuff, but you don't see the other stuff like this. It's like nature nurture though, isn't it? If you're grown up in an environment that's like this, then the product's just gonna be what some of these people have become.
And why are you here?
I ask him.
Y él me dice, bueno, yo soy de Caracas.
And he says, I'm from Caracas.
Y mi delito fue haber secuestrado a tres españolas.
My crime was that I kidnapped three Spanish girls.
Robala.
I stole from them.
Y violala.
Raped them.
Y matala.
And killed them.
Le metieron los 26 años.
Okay,
y él era
26
muy...
years.
Era muy problemático dentro de la cárcel. Genera mucha violencia.
And he was very violent inside the penitentiaries.
Él agarró y le estaba buscando problemas a otro preso.
He started a fight with another inmate. He took a machete and cut his head off.
Entonces agarró y tiró la cabeza contra el suelo.
He broke the head against the floor.
Le sacó los sesos y empezó a comerse los puñales.
Took the brains out and ate them with a spoon.
I must say, everybody who's subject has been a sort of mass murderer.
Mm-hmm.
No one's been in for possession of marijuana or anything lightweight.
I know, when they were like, yeah, we were in jail for 3 months for conspiracy to supply, they're like, okay.
Yeah,
I've just come off of a 25-year spell for kidnapping five tourists, and raping three women. And,
prisons here, you're handcuffed everywhere. They like walk you to your cell, to the bus, or tell you when to eat and when to like shit basically. But there, they basically just throw all the prisoners in together. They don't handcuff them and they let them like get to their own devices, which I really thought was strange.
And you're a bit to expect, if you know what I mean. People getting murdered and it's Venezuela, if I talk about that, I mean. It's not exactly England. A crime in itself, letting people just do that.
Well, over there, they got hard, I mean, really hard over there, and here, it's just easy. You know, you have your own TV, you have your own free view.
One's a holiday camp and the other one's like a death chamber sort of thing. Stop your dreaming, let yourself fall. We'll call the notion. We can work it out. We can work it out, baby. Go ahead, lose yourself inside this opportunity.
Bye then, see you in England.
This is Captain Chaos.
Captain Chaos?
Captain Chaos. Captain Chaos is Sadie's nickname, yeah.
Doing that. really made me more confident. I've never experienced things like that before. I've seen different cultures and how they react to different people, and how easy or how hard life is in somewhere else. I've just brought back a more positive attitude from going around doing the experience. I'll tell people all the time about it, and I think they got sick and tired of me now saying it, but I'm still going to bang my teeth about it anyway.
It's only us that are going to change ourselves, sort of thing, and it's only like we're basically the masters of our future, and I do believe in that a lot. Like, ever since I've come back, that's why I found it a lot easier not to get into trouble, because I tried to take responsibility for my actions.
I don't get myself into any more trouble, and I know how to avoid it, I know that. No flag on the marble arch, but listen, love is not some kind of victim. No, it's a cold.
I don't really want to go. I could stay here, but I don't really want. You gotta go.
Hallelujah. Love is not some kind of victory march. No, it's a cold and it's ever broken. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Like what vintage and that sort of lifestyle was about.
Winona Ryder was here yesterday.
Winona Ryder, hey? Well, she's had a brush with the law.
And we have a huge shoe room in the back.
Great. No wonder you've managed to get yourself a sweet little girlfriend working here.
Wow, I haven't shaved this morning.
Getting on.
Oh, he drives me nuts sometimes. Oh, we still like
him. he's head honcho at Discovery Sailing Project.
Last winter he was working on boats and there were some young girls there as well that he'd met, and he was giving a quite a lot of banter with them. I said to him, what's happened to the shy reserve kid that came in July? And he turned around quite strongly and said, he's gone.
Well, I've got another potential opportunity. It's going to be a 6-month horse ride.
Oh, fucking hell.
Oh, I'm delighted for him.
I was so grateful that you had the opportunity to go away with yourself, Sadie.
We've just come herring down from London because we're going to catch up with Fly Fisher.
Done a little bit of research, and by the time you've gone down to Venezuela and go down the South America.
We go back to Venezuela!
Shit.
Daffy said you've got to keep him out for pirates. I see if they're shooting pirates. No, they come out of speedbacks, they start shooting at them.
And the cameraman Johnny man.
Johnny.
Old tight DJ Johnny with a camera.